Hello everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you guys are. Welcome for another episode of How to Do Watercolor. This series is all about fundamentals. I'm going to do people. If you haven't watched, I've done a video about people on the front and people on the side, and I'm going to do people in the back as well. So to start with, the sketches usually I do a Faber-Castell mechanical TK-944. I have a few synthetic brush. These are Jackson synthetic brush. They're cheap as chips, but they do the job. And I also have a mop. It's a zero size Pro Arte mop. The paper I'm using is a 300 gram Saunders paper, rough. And for the inclination, I put in a couple of cans of beans. That gives my inclination. And on my right, I have a John Pike palette. And I've got two bottles of water. One is slightly dirtier than the other, but I just used one to take out more of the pigment, and the other one is for a slightly cleaner water. So before I start, maybe one of the couple of people, they've been asking about how do you get a skin tone. So if I just give you a few minutes how to do that. So obviously you're taking red, a little bit of yellow. So I'm taking pyrrole red, lemon yellow, and then make it a little bit of blue. And I'm taking a little bit of ultramarine blue, and that gives you a rough, that sort of skin tone. If you wanted to make it lighter, obviously you take a bit more water, and every time you change the shade, you add a little more yellow or a little more blue, you control it. But basically I would say that one is good too. Yellow, a little more pigment. And I hope you can see that. That's what you're trying to do. I would say majority is red. I would say 70% red, 15% to get you some sort of shades of red. I'm gonna add a little more red. And you can get paler and so on and so forth. All right, so to the exercise, what we have at the moment, roughly, I'm gonna draw that size. So there's two people, and there's also the line. The body language just gives me an idea of where the person comes in, and everything is very economical. I'm just doing simple sketches. So, as you see, very economical, and then also I draw these lines to know where my leg or the action needs to go. So, a little bit of boot. A big bag, and then the couple is holding hand. Maybe this body needs to be a little on the side. A little bit of boot. There's a little rough here, and I'm exaggerating a little bit, but that's it. So maybe the boot comes over here, and the first person. I will try to make it a little smaller because I worry that I'm making the bodies a little too big. His hoodie, his leg. Yes, a little bit of hair, and the next person. So it's got one leg there, one leg here, a little. So I'm always using construction lines or reference lines to know where I'm, where my sketch is going. It gives me an idea to be a little more precise, a human-like, and it's got a cap. There's a third. I'm not sure if it's a boy or a girl. And roughly that's one person. A little bit of bell bottom, and there's another person, rectangle, has his buttocks. That's about it, and this one is slightly on the side. So I'm doing the leg, the skirt, and the next leg goes there's a bun and there's lady and then there's a back as well. Same thing, slightly the head sits here, there's a sunglass. There's a bum, there's a hand. Oh, I forgot the lady's hand. And there's a big backpack. And the leg is in that shape. And so roughly and the bell stops there. That's it. So also, especially with the water sketches in landscape and cityscapes, it's good to have a little wet. I prefer the sketches to be a little wet so that you can carry on. And as I said, to get the skin tones, I'm doing a little bit of red, I'm adding a little bit of yellow to make it orange, and in this case I'm using a ultramarine blue just to get a shade. And I start with just a neck over here. And I'm going with a little more darker hair and ultramarine. Jacket or a top. Just a little bit of hand, and I'm using a little bit of indigo mixed with green. As you notice, I'm not doing exactly the same color, but taking the color from the palette. I'm doing ultramarine blue for the shirts. The painting looks more for black, but I think I'm happy with ultramarine blue. And also notice I'm not washing my brush, I'm just using the colors and dripping. And this one is burnt. Okay, so I'm doing the brush. The shirt is a little bit of gray. So gray shirt is black, and here's a little ginger. I will let it bleed. So this one is a little darker than what I want, but I would manage. And I'm using cerulean blue for the pant. It looks like a jeans. I could have used black, but I'm just using cerulean blue. And coming to the next one, he's using, I just picked up color for the palette. This one is greenish. And dark blue pants. I'm going very fast at the moment. The next one has got a black shirt. Black shirt. Dark blue pants, and I'll come back and then do the shoes. It's got a bit of a indigo cap, and if I put in a little bit of texture, I'm happy with that. The next lady has a black shirt, lady or a gentleman, I'm not sure. And it's got, let's make it a red ginger. And it's got a blackish pant. That's it. And I'm using a little bit of Van Dyke brown for his shoes. The next lady has blue stripe shirt. I'm gonna just happy with that. French. And light shoes. Okay, she's got blonde hair. And that would do. Moving on. Let's do yellow ochre. That one is a bit too green. Okay, so, and a hand, a leg, and she got some brown shoes. I'm using yellow. And she's got black hair, just got a black bag, and I would add a black soap. Rolling on, she has a black backpack, slightly dark hair. She's got a gray shirt. There's a little bit more liquid. I'm just going to take that and a little bit of burnt sienna. Yes, that I'm happy with it. I'm going to step two. So I'm doing, one is a bit too dark. Yeah, that one is fine. So I'm adding a little bit of shadows and where you expect. So and shadow and her boots. Shadow over there, and I will call it a day. Excuse me. So, a little bit of gray, adding a little bit of creases, and the pant. And even though he's wearing the white shoes, I'm going to just make it darker, darker, and darker, and the head is a shadow, and a little bit of shadow under your ears. These small details make or break a painting. And he's got a very let's do that. And squeeze. And it's got a I will leave that. Probably it's a little dark, but I will come back and then add a little more details to that. And the next guy is black. So you're looking at mostly black with a little more that's it. Same thing with the lady or the dude, mostly black. And comes there in red. That's it. A little bit of dark, and as you see, you just use a light reference and then you go from there. There's nothing too complicated about it, especially when in a cityscapes of this size, the humans are usually about 1 or 2 inches or maybe 2.5-3 centimeters. So you don't need too many details. This is plenty detail. So adding a little more detail. Just got a bag. And I'm not and that's it. So the bag. Some more details. There's a glass. And a few more details with the pant. If I add a sketch and then also a little bit of shadow, or that anchors the painting. Always add a little bit of shadow. So a little dark just on the body. There you go. So easy people sketches from the back. I hope you enjoyed the show. If you like, please hit the like button. Consider subscribing the video, and also don't forget to hit the notification button so that you don't miss on any of the new videos. Till next time, have a good night and keep practicing watercolors. Bye.